A name that I learned years ago in school has sprung to life for me here at Cluny. It was simply a place that I had to learn about to fill in a test so many decades ago. But here in Cluny, I began to understand for the first time the magnitude and the glory of the Abbey of Cluny, a church that was for centuries the largest in Christendom. That's one thing. And to experience the extraordinary efforts at restoration, the graphics that allow you in a kind of 3D virtual reality to experience what it must have been like to walk through this church bathed in pillars and streaming with light. And you notice I'm using past tense because the church is no longer here. All that remains are partial ruins. Why? Because in the wake of the French Revolution, it was decided to dismantle this church stone by stone, pillar by pillar, stone carving, icon by icon. A road was cut right through the middle, and it was literally carted off for more useful things. And the people here had to watch it happen. The destruction of sacred sites, it's really nothing new. And when we stand at Cluny, we remember just how easily it can happen. Even to something as massive and solid and magnificent as the Abbey of Cluny.